Hi guys, welcome to Trendie Tech, the channel where I help you to discover and enjoy the supernatural powers of tech. There are lots of softwares out there for doing anything, but I fish out the best, the easiest to use, and most importantly, the safest for you. I upload a number of videos per week, so subscribe and hit the bell icon to ensure you don't miss any of my videos. If you enjoyed this video, consider giving it a thumbs up. Let's get started. In this video, we are going to look at a software for converting files. This software makes file conversion so easy that even my grandma should be able to do this. There is no need for registration or sign up, even though you can do that if you wish. All the popular file formats that you know are supported by this software, talking about PDF to document or the other way around, image to GIF, MKV to MP4, any kind of file format that you can think of at all is supported by this conversion. So let's see how it works. Up here at the topmost part of the window, we have these options. Now, these ones lead to a third-party software, and these softwares usually require that they put watermark on your video or your image or whatever you are editing, or you make payment and then they remove the watermark. So I don't use them at all. I have better ways of doing the stuff listed up here. Let me know down in the comments if you want me to make a video on any of them. Now, down here is what we'll be using. This bar right here is all we need, where we have choose files and all that. But if you like, you can go up here to the convert. Before we go ahead, let me also mention that you can do this on your mobile device. It's actually very simple to do it on your mobile device too. So if you want to follow along on your mobile device, then do so. All right, so you can come here and you can choose from here what kind of conversion you want to do: video converter, audio converter, image converter, document, and then ebook. Anything at all, as you can see from here. But as I said, this is all we actually need to do our conversions. There are so many ways of getting your files to convert. You can click on the choose files and this should take you to your file system, right? And then you choose a file from there, or you can drag and drop a file. You can do whichever you find the easiest. You can also use these ones over here. This is for obtaining your file from Dropbox, and this is for obtaining your file from Google Drive. So if you have your file on Google Drive, you don't need to download it before uploading it and all that. This will ask you to connect your Google Drive with the software and then you can download your file from there. Okay, so let's go ahead and click on the choose file and choose our file. Now my file is on the desktop. Let us try the document to PDF conversion. So I'm going to choose this file right here. As you can see, it's a Word document file. I'm going to open it. Okay, so this is what we have. As you can see, it's very simple. As I've been saying, this is the file we just opened or we just uploaded. This is where we choose the file format you want to convert it to. We have a number of options here. If you want to convert it to some kind of image, we have the PNG image and then we have the JPEG image. I know it confuses some of you the difference between PNG and JPEG. PNG is usually a high quality form of the image, and JPG or JPEG is more like a smaller or a lesser quality version. So if you compress a video, it usually ends up being a JPEG. And JPEG and JPG are the same thing, actually. So if you want to convert it to a document too, you have these options. You have the PDF, you have document, and you have document X. Okay, the file is already a document X. That's why we don't have the option of document X. The difference between the document and document X, once again, they are the same thing. The DOC, which is doc, is an older version of DOCX. So if you are creating any file today, you should be using DOCX, but they both work the same way. And you can convert to TXT as well. And we have here the ebooks. The most popular one among these ones for ebook is the EPUB. Usually books from Amazon and some other book selling platforms come in the form of EPUB. You can easily come to this platform and upload the file and convert it to PDF by selecting PDF here. Let's go ahead and select PDF and see how this works. Now, once you've selected, you see there's this text here that tells us that we are ready to convert our file. So we can just go ahead and click here. If you want to, you can add more files. I'll just click on convert and wait for it to do its job. All right, so because my file is small, it just took a few seconds and then it's done converting. Now I can get my converted file by clicking on this download button over here, and it will take me to my file system, and I will choose a location and a name if I want to give it a different name. The way this software works, whenever you convert a file, it is added to your files over here, whether you've registered or not. This, I think, saves it in your browser, so the next time you come, you actually still have access to this file. Here are the two files that I've converted so far. I'll go back to the home by clicking on this Convertio over here, and then we'll try another conversion and see. Let's try and convert the MKV video format, which is not supported by a lot of video players, into MP4, which is supported by virtually every player out there. So once I've uploaded the file, I just come here and then select video and select MP4 from here. MP4 is here. And then I'll click on convert. And it should just take a few seconds or a few minutes, depending on the size of my file. And it is done. Alright, so once again, once it's done, I can easily download my file here. And concerning the saving of your files into your My Files, the file will only be saved for 24 hours. But in my experience, it seems it takes a little longer than 24 hours. Because after I've gone there a few days later, I still kind of see my files. Alright. Now, the last thing I want to show you before we end this video is the Chrome extension of this software. It's not too necessary. It's really not too necessary because it's easy to get to and it's easy to use. But if you want to use the Chrome extension, this is how you can get it. This is what I mean by Chrome extension. It gives you a little icon here, which you can just click at any time and then go into the software. So to get the Chrome extension, you want to go to Chrome Web Store. So you can search something like Chrome Web Store. And you choose this very first link over here to go to the Chrome Web Store. And then over here, you can search for the software we are looking for, which in this case is Convertio. This is it right here. Because I already have it, it says rate. But if you don't have it, you have this button that says add to Chrome. Go ahead and click on that button. It will install it and then add it to your Chrome. So you should have an icon over here that looks like this. And you can easily click on the icon and do your conversion with ease. You can do all these type of conversions. Okay, so that's it for this video, guys. As I said, I have a ton of these resources that makes life much easier. So do not forget to subscribe, guys. I know you enjoyed this video and that is why you are still here. So go ahead and give me a thumbs up. I will see you in my next video.